no, you didn't get the car. So and so on, you must go to so and so. And they go, well, yes, don't bother going to so and so because that isn't what they say. All right, well, what do they say? Oh, they say that it's prehistoric. They say it's prehistoric. And yours telling me in a very cat-like way that it's not, I better just purchase it in case. Because the answer is, if it ain't prehistoric, why did they make it now? Why did they make it in the 10th century AD? That is also that element of, it might have only been used for 100 years, the way that it was intended to. And then a bunch of might have come in and gone, do this. Wow, that's amazing. You know, we built this barrow over here, we've created this effect. It worries me sometimes that we live in such a static culture. You know, like we live in a house that's bright pink that was built in 1800. When we moved in, I got a video blue wall because I didn't want to do photos in London anymore. So we just painted one of the walls video blue in the back. There's an old squash wall. But the authorities came around and said, you can't paint video blue here. That's like ridiculous. It's in the middle of nowhere. And I went, hold on. A bright pink house here. Oh yes, I know, but that's an acceptable part. That's culturally acceptable. And I said, yeah, but if you go to the west of Ireland, you'll get like really bright yellow houses, really bright blue houses, really bright pink houses. I said, if you go to Sweden, you'll actually get something that you might find weird. You get bright orange houses. You know, and you'll get them next to like another bright orange house, which is a slightly different orange. And I'm going, whoa! And in the end, I just fought them on it because I said, look, it's just got a real practical nature. And I tried to explain that, it's so weird about, well, you can't do that. And I just think, well, culture never used to be in a stasis.
And on that note, what really pisses you off in life, and obviously that's something that's drawn on, you know, touched a nerve with you, what else really gets into your skin?
Because so many things.
Relate to that.
Yeah, I don't know, yeah, just the brutalising, just culture is just so brutalising for people. Just that. For me it's really hard because, you know, I have a really good life. So if I do stuff, you know, my publisher's in West London, and I drive into West London, and London's interesting. Whoa! I like London, what a cool looking place. Like, I'm seeing it in a totally different light to everybody, so, you know, I can even drive inventively in traffic. You know, I mean, there's people that drive inventively in traffic because they're being downed by the traffic.
Yeah.
I'll be this guy who does that.
Yeah.
Death will be the portal. And once I crash through, I've got a horrible feeling that I believe in reincarnation because I've learned any evidence for it for myself, but I know there's lots of evidence for other people. But what happened for myself, I just figure I don't honestly think that I get the information and the answer when I crash through the portal into the next world, because I do think that it's
And what would you want to be remembered for?
Being ubiquitous in Britain. I want people to know Cathy was here. And it could be anywhere on the British Isles. All people stand on the hilltops going, Cooper's doing it.
Yeah.
Just knowing. Do you know what it works like? The great thing is, maybe you know, writing your notes there.
Yeah.
That's it. In fact, you don't even have to have a photo because in fact you've written it. Do you know what? With the online square, it was 10 really detailed notebooks. And every one of them, I'll look back and I go, notes under a bush, you know, pissing rain. End of the Isle of Humour. Yes.
Yes.
So even in 100 years, if nobody can remember me apart from like one, you know, that one could go, you know, well, everything's to me, it's like, well, at least he did. I can't believe they used to think that.